Kingdom come, O God. We thank you today. Now, God, we ask that you would go into every prison ward today. God, we ask that you would heal and deliver. God, we ask that you would set free. God, we thank you, oh God, for what you already done. God, there are those, hallelujah, that the devil is trying to put in the trap, oh God. You have set them free. God, we ask that you would keep them free, oh God. Touch their mind. Touch their hearts, oh God. And in the name of Jesus, touch that son. Touch that daughter, oh God. Save and deliver today. We thank you now. Now go into every home in this community, oh God. Meet every need in the name of Jesus. We thank you today. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Give God a shout of thanksgiving. Come on, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Anybody else been redeemed? Hallelujah. Do you know that you know that you have been redeemed? God bless you on this another Sunday morning that the Lord has allowed us to come together, amen, to worship, magnify him, amen. I'm like David, amen. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, amen. And I thank God, amen, this parking lot is our house today. This parking lot is the sanctuary today. Amen. And I just believe, amen, if the birds can praise him with the tweet. Amen. If the dog can praise him with the bark. If the cow can praise him with the moo. You got a right to give God some praise. Are there any praises on the ladder today? Hallelujah. Glory to God. So glad I'm saved. I'm saved. So glad I'm saved. Amen. God bless you once again. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Amen. On this the Lord day. Amen. Those of you, amen, that are joining us by Facebook, God bless you. We thank God for you. Amen. And especially our neighbors. Amen. Our friends. Amen. All of those that have made this what it is on today. You are welcome here, amen, to be a part of the Great New Bible Church of God in Christ service, amen. Whosoever will, let them come, amen, amen. God bless you, amen. Just to give you, amen, the order of our service that we're still in, amen, and we still lift up Jesus, we're still magnifying the Lord, amen, worship service. Amen. Sunday school every Sunday morning at 9 to 9:30. Sunday school, you can join us, amen, on the call line every Sunday morning from 9 to 9:30. That number is 978-990-5000. Again, to join us on the call line to study God's word, amen, is 978-990-5000. And the linking code, amen, the access code, 60278. Again, 60278. Will you join us in Sunday school? Amen. And then at 11 o'clock, we're right here on the parking lot, worshiping, magnifying God. Amen. Every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock, we're right here in the drive-up worship. Amen. And then once again, our midweek word and prayer. I said our midweek word and prayer. Amen. That same number that you use to access Sunday school, you can access word and prayer every Wednesday evening at 8 p.m. That's Wednesday evening at 8 p.m. Join us on the line, amen, and receive a word from the Lord. How many love the Lord again on today? Hallelujah. We're just enjoying Jesus. We thank God for our assistant pastor, amen, Elder Vanderbilt, who led us in such a wonderful prayer and scripture on this morning. Amen. And to the deacon brothers, to the missionaries, to the mothers. Amen. Can I just say all the saints of God? Amen. Is that all right? All the saints of God. Amen. That includes everybody and excludes nobody. Amen. So we're thankful. Certainly we missed the First Lady. Amen. And her absence on today. We're praying for her. Amen. All of those that may be ill. Amen. Dealing with conditions. Amen. Sickness. Amen. Those that are in the hospital, we're continuing to lift them up. Amen. Those that are bereaved families. Amen. We're lifting them up today. Amen. We have a prayer thing going on here at Greater New Bible Way. Amen. We ordained this year. Amen. More prayer, more power. I'll say that again. We ordained this year in January as being the year of more prayer and more power. So we just praying. Amen. There's prayer circles going on. Amen. Just about every day of the week, somebody is lifting up Jesus through the word of prayer. So we thank God for those that have been faithful and continue to dedicate. Amen. And lifting up the ministry. Amen. And all of those that are sick and ill. Amen. We continue to pray for those, our people that are on the front line, the nurses, the doctors, the police, the firemen, those civic leaders. Amen. Our governors, the mayor. Amen. Our, amen, bishop. Amen. Our international bishop. Bishop Blake, our state bishop, Bishop Anderson, amen, and their cabinets. We thank God for the leadership of our church, amen. Those that lead us, that are leading us in such a time as this, amen. How many of you are ready for a word from the Lord? How many of you need a word from the Lord in this season? It is the word of God that is going to keep us. It is the word of God that is going to hold us strong. Hallelujah. That gives us hope. That encourages us. That picks us up. Hallelujah. The word of God. Amen. We have a great man of God that is getting ready to come and declare the word on today. I thank and praise God for him. Amen. He's one of those, amen, that you can call on. Amen. And he's right there. I'm so glad, amen. We're so blessed here, the Bible Way family, to have this man of God that is getting ready to come. On the other Frederick Quick, come, amen.
You bow your heads briefly and meditate in Jesus in the privacy of your mind. Father, this morning, we lift our eyes to see your glory. We open our hearts to receive your love. We engage our minds to understand your truth. Lord, we offer our sons to praise your name. We praise you because you are God. We praise you and we lift you up. We magnify your name. We praise you because you, the Lord, Master, super ruler of this world. We want to tell you, thank you for how far you brought us. Lord, we thank you for what you're going to do for us now in the future. Lord, we thank you for exceeding our expectations. We thank you for taking us where we couldn't go on our own. And this morning, I just want to say, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless his name. First, give honor to God, Pastor Rogers, who is the Lord working the church and is diligent in the services of our God, who is still giving of himself without reservation. He deserves your prayers and support. First Lady, in her absence, I want to see Mother Rogers, Brother Maris, my First Lady, Sister Quick, and all of God's people. It is always a pleasure to be in your presence. This morning, I'm not going to take up a lot of time. I'm going to dispense with the preambles of my nature and get about the business of preaching the word of God. Over in John, the first chapter, the 14th verse, it says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Over in John, things were written that we might believe. In the epistle of John, things were written that we may know. If you could have Jesus and not know it, you might lose him, not miss him. This morning, now, we want you to know that you have Jesus. He who forgets the history of the past is destined to fail in the future. Today is a testimony or evidence in support of that fact. The flu of 1917, we are having the same mistakes made today that were made in 1917. You can make choices and decisions that will affect your entire life. That's the reason I want to talk about sense. As I said, this is a narrative message really system or characterized by telling of a story. Or if you go with me to Judges, the 14th chapter, if you get your little chance to read chapters 13 to 16, it tells the story of the life of Samson. Samson's birth was a supernatural version of God. His parents, his mother, could not get pregnant. But she promised God if he would give her a son, she would dedicate her life to serving him. She prayed and God gave her a son. She was so committed to God that she made him a Nazarite. A Nazarite is an Israeli who has dedicated his life to the purpose of God. Samson accepted this call and assignment on his life to be a Nazarite. To be a Nazarite, you had to make three commitments. You couldn't drink, you couldn't cut your hair, and you couldn't touch any dead thing. Samson was like many of us. We were dedicated to the Father. Some people will tell you that Samson's strength was in his hair. But if you read the scripture, you will find that every time Samson did something supernatural, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. Our strength is not in the kind of clothes we wear, or the home we live in, or the car we drive. Our strength is in the fact that the power of Jesus lives within our hearts. Oh, bless his name. The Bible says that John the Baptist wore camel hair. And I take that to be that God wants us to be different from the world. My character is not to be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of my mind. Being a Nazarite meant that he would not touch any dead. He made this commitment to God as well as his mother. And Samson is a man who had a assignment on his life, a great purpose. If you read chapter 13 through 16, you will see that some of the great exploits he made in his lifetime. He was a judge for 20 years. He caught 300 foxes and he destroyed and burnt the fields of his enemy. He took the jawbone of an ass and killed 1,000 men. When his enemies tried to tie him down with ropes, they broke like strings. Samson had a great life, a great purpose. But his problem was he couldn't get his flesh under control. He is another boy, his destiny, and I'm afraid that some of Samson's descendants are here this morning. Some people who are going to compromise their destinies because they can't get their flesh under control. This is a man who missed out on all the diversions that God had for him. He ended up compromising, and he ended up losing his life prematurely because he couldn't control his flesh. He ended up in the lap of Delilah, another woman other than his wife. And I don't have to go far to talk about people who ended up in the lap of another woman other than their wife. And it caused them their careers, and it caused them their jobs, and it caused them their life. You know what I'm talking about. It's the truth. You know why? That's why we're so quiet right now. We're thinking about the Delilahs and the Davids in your life. And if you're a millennium, you're probably thinking about Tyrone. Because somebody just wanna call Tyrone. Oh, bless his name. Samson poured out his heart to this woman. She took the information out of him, took the information, cut his hair, and caused him to lose his life. A lot of people have sacrificed their life for a momentary prayer. For just a momentary prayer. Let me tell you, it didn't happen overnight. He just didn't wake up in a relationship with Delilah. Over the course of time, he made small compromises. It didn't just happen overnight. That's what messes us up. Small compromise. Over in Judges, the 16th chapter, and the first verse, Samson saw a prostitute, and he went and slept with her. He had an affinity for women. He loved women. He loved the look of women. And I want to give you a little advice. There's a whole lot of Delilahs. Oh, bless his name. I'll give you my subject at the end. And it got him in trouble. Small compromises. He didn't get here overnight. And the first compromise is found in chapter 14. Can you walk with me through this incident? That sets the stage for the rest of his life. That causes him to fall. That causes his downfall. Judges the 14th chapter and the 5th verse. Early in this 14th chapter, he finds a woman and he went to be with her. He wanted her to be his wife, and he's in good shape at this point. He tells his parents about her in verse 5. He went down to the vineyard of Tanakh with his parents. He's on his way to Tanakh. Now a young lion comes to attack him. He's on his way to introduce his parents to this person he wants to marry. Anytime you have a purpose, you are trying to accomplish something worthwhile, you are going to have to run into some young lions. Sometimes you never know who that young lion is going to be. Something is going to come against you to destroy you. Something going to come against you to try to stop you. Something is going to come against you to defeat you. In Samson's case, it was a young rolling lion. Listen, brothers and sisters, something is going to come to stop you. A young lion, or old, not an old, toothless lion, a young lion. You got some lions that's hard to handle. With your human strength, it's almost impossible to defeat a young lion on your own. In verses 6, a young lion came up on him and he tore the young lion apart like a little goat. He killed the young lion by himself. The Spirit of the Lord came upon him and gave him the strength to do something he couldn't do on his own. Whatever the lion is that's trying to destroy you, overtake you, God will give you the strength to overcome it and give you the victory over it, as long as you are walking within the parameters of the principles of God. You don't have to worry about the devil. The crossover in Psalms, it says, fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be envious of workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down as the grass. God will give you supernatural powers to defeat the young lion in your life. This was not the first time that Samson's life, that the Spirit of God had come upon him and gave him the power to overcome. The difference between that time and now, the Spirit of the God would come upon Samson for a particular assigned task, or a particular assigned duty. When that duty and task was complete, the Spirit would go back to God. But we have the privilege and the blessings of having the Holy Ghost dwell with us. And the Spirit does not depart from us. He's with us every day. God gives us the power with the Holy Ghost to do what only He can do. Not only conquer, but kill the things that are trying to destroy us. There are some things that God will kill in your life. There are some relationships in your life that God will kill. There are some habits that He will kill in your life. There are some things that would take you out that God would kill in your life. Oh, bless His name. I don't care what the problem is in your life. The Holy Ghost will give you the power to kill it, to overcome it in your life. Oh, bless His name. I wish I had somebody to pray with me for a while. There are relationships you were trying to hook up that God killed in your life. There are people that you wanted to hook up with that God killed in your life. That's what Samson did to the lion. Things were designed to kill him, but he killed it. Over in verse 7, it says he went down and talked with the woman, and she pleased him. And after a time, he returned to take her
and he turned aside to see the carcass of the lion. And behold, there was a swarm of bees and honey in the carcass of the lion. He's going back to get his wife. While he's going back, he sees the dead lion carcass. The dead lion he killed, he decided to go take a closer look. Oh, bless his name. In verse 8, and behold, a swarm of bees were in the carcass of the lion. Now here's the problem. He goes over and takes a look in the carcass of the lion, and he discovers that there is honey inside the carcass. You get in trouble when you go to check out something God has already killed in your life. Can I do this again? I say you get in trouble when you go to check on something God has killed in your life. You miss the point. You get in trouble when you just call to see how they're doing. You just stop by to see what's going on. Samson found out that there was honey inside the lion's carcass. He didn't have to go over, get down, and look up in the carcass of the lion. That's what gets you in trouble, checking on it, driving back to see who's there. Oh, bless his name. I can't get no help up in here. He got in trouble because he wanted to check it out. And he wanted to see something up in it. That's he lacked. He lacked honey. And how many of you know that your carcass got just what you like? She or he has done do just what you like them. But the carcass is going to cost you your destiny. Oh, bless his name. Don't do it. It's dead. It's over. It's ended. But you are still dabbling. You're still fooling around. You're still messing around with something God has already killed in your life. Oh, bless his name. He liked the smell of it. He liked the look of it. And he had had honey before. And he had memories that reminded him of how honey tastes. How good honey is. You got to have the love of God that supersedes anything the world has to offer. You need to have an encounter with God that smothers out anything the world has to offer. The Bible says, taste and see that God is good. Oh, bless his name. The Bible says he's better than honey. The Bible says, oh, taste and see that God is good. How bless his name. I'm preaching up in here. Y'all can't hear. Oh, bless his name. Here's the problem. He's a Nazarene, and he's not to touch anything that's dead. You are missing with something that you know as a Christian you ain't got no business doing. You are messing with something you know you ain't got no business being with. You're in a place where you know you ain't got no business at. You're messing with a drug, and you know you ain't got no business messing with drugs. You're at the nightclub, and you know you ain't got no business at the nightclub. And it's going to cost you your destiny. Look at your neighbor and tell them it ain't worth it. Oh, bless his name. I'm going to go speak
red man.
It's a moon. It's a mountain. It's just a little momentary thrill. There's a little momentary thrill worth missing out on God. There's a little orgasm worth missing out on what God has for you. There's a little high worth missing out on God. I got to go hood with some of you. I know it looks good. I know it smells good. I know it tastes good. But I want to leave you with this honey alone. Sow a thought, reap a feeling. Sow a feeling, reap a action. Sow a action, reap a habit. Sow a habit, reap a destiny. Leave the honey alone. Don't Facebook it. Don't MySpace it. Don't message it. Leave the honey alone. Dancing with the devil and wondering why you in hell. I want you to know that the devil will take you farther than you want to go and keep you longer than you want to. God has a message for you this morning. He says over in Romans, if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart that Jesus Christ raised from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
That's love flows because God is in control. A church where God is really real. Hi, my name is Dennis Rogers, pastor here at the Greater New Bible Way Church of God in Christ. I would like to welcome you to our